Performance USA, the greatest entertainers in America, is requested by you, the fighting men of the United States Armed Forces throughout the world. Command Performance, presented this week and every week, till it's over, over there. Okay, man, it's chow time here on Command Performance, so line up for that international mess of entertainment. Cook to order to fill the orders that you guys write to Command Performance, care of Special Service Division, Los Angeles, USA. And speaking of cooking, we're cooking with high octane again tonight, serving America's top music, sweetened with a bit of that stuff called glamour and throwing in a few eggs laid by your favorite comedians. And coming out now to work over a hot mic, a man who's worked all day over a hot orchestra, your commanding officer of this command performance, Professor K. Kaiser.
Well, thank you, Ken Carpenter, and evening, folks. How are y'all? Well, we sure...
Professor, I have completed writing a new poem, and I am resigned to reading same.
Iskabibble, well, can't you see we're just starting the show? Now beat it.
Thank you. I will read same. A poem about soldiers, entitled Soldiers.
Very clever.
Oh, I wish I was a soldier, because then I would be able to sit around the bunkhouse and pin up Betty Grable.
Come on, get out of here. Now, well, fellas, as I was going to say, your international clam bake is really kicking up the dust tonight. Yes, sir, we've got so many stars, we've got stars getting autographs from the stars. So let's start the proceedings. First, for Tony Leodini on New Guinea, for Pill Pusher Pete and Carl Wolf chasing land crabs at 915, Clarence Kaplan at 871, Sway at 462, Corporal Chuli Wulu at 948, and for good old King Cole sitting over there on Malta, here's Uncle Sammy's number one ditty of the hour with Harry, Diane, Julie, Jack, and Max. Here we go.
Let's get lost. Let's get lost. Let 'em send out alarms.
And though they think us rather rude, let's tell the world we're in that crazy mood. Let's defrost in a romantic mist.
Let's get crossed
right off everybody's list to celebrate this night we found each other.
Thank you, kids. Well, gang, you ask Command Performance who the newest comedy team is back home, and our spies report that it's Alan Carney and Wally Brown ringing the bell for RKO in Adventures of a Rookie. Well, they've come here direct from work and dressed in moving picture GI to do a bit from their new flicker. The scene, a big room at the induction center. A couple hundred rookies are taking their army aptitude test. And right up in the front row, having a tough time copying off each other's papers, Wally Brown and Alan Carney.
All right, man, there'll be a five-minute break. Go out for a smoke and report back the same seat for your final test.
Hey, got a match?
Yeah, sure.
Swell, I want to... Hey, how did you do?
How do you do?
No, I mean, how did you do in your IQ test?
Oh, pretty good up until that question about A and B driving to Chicago. That's where I got stuck.
That was the first question.
Yeah, I know. That's where I got stuck.
That's where you got stuck.
I didn't understand it.
Didn't, huh? It's very simple. Look, A and B are driving to Chicago. Now, that's clear, isn't it?
No. Right away, I get stuck. Where'd they get the gasoline to drive to Chicago?
What difference does that make?
What difference? How could they drive to Chicago without any gasoline?
Oh. They had gas. A had a B book, B had a B book, B had an A book. They both had an uncle who died and left them a C-book.
Gee, I don't even have an uncle.
That's fine. Look, let's get back to the problem. A and B are driving to Chicago. A starts an hour ahead of B.
Why?
Well, he thought that the... What do you mean, why?
Why should he start an hour ahead of B? We got a war going on. We got rationing. Why didn't they drive together? Look at all the tires and gasoline they were saved.
They couldn't ride together. They didn't know one another. They'd never met. And I'm beginning to be sorry he ever met you.
You don't like me, huh?
Of course I like you. Now, let me explain the problem. A and B are driving to Chicago.
They got their Uncle C-book.
Right. Now, you're a very nice fellow, and I like you. And your mother likes you, doesn't she?
Oh, she's crazy about me.
Sure, she's just crazy. Now, look, A and B are driving... You, let's assume that you're A. You leave an hour ahead of B.
I am a what?
You're a... What do you mean, what?
Well, I gotta be a something, like a truck driver or a soldier or a, you know...
You're a nothing.
You don't like me again, huh?
I like you. I think you're wonderful. Look, there really isn't any A. You are you.
Well, you just said I was A.
You are A. You're also you. See?
Oh.
Now do you get it?
No.
Look! A and B are driving to Chicago 300 miles. A starts an hour ahead of B. B catches them in 3 hours. A's average speed is 20 miles an hour. Now, what is B's?
Bees?
Yeah.
That's easy.
Sure.
Bees are little bugs with honey in them.
Come on,
get out of here. Well, thanks a lot, Alan Carney and Wally Brown. Next, we're calling Sergeant Don Heron and the 1st Paratroop Gang to go overseas, and Fireman 2nd Class Virgil T. Roten, and Blackie Waldrop and Art Garcia at Navy 203. Hello, Sarge Murray and the Static Chasers at 860. Say, Sarge, we told Bing about your letter to Command Performance. And howdy to the clothing store gang over in Shropshire, England, and to R. Wilson with the RAF at Wigtonshire, Scotland. Greetings to Frank Heppel, KFGPO, London. Thanks to Corporal Snyder at 635 and the Michiganders, the Pensy Boys, the Windy City Outfit, the Arkies, Okies, and Missouri Mules. Fair dinkum to A.W. Armstrong at Perth in Western Australia. And for a few million Yanks and some 30 United Nations, come on, chillin', yes, dance.
The kids all call him Johnny Zero.
Sassy Sally Mason with all the rest of the gang.
All the kids all call him Johnny Zero.
Zero.
In school they always used to say,
Johnny got a zero.
Johnny got a zero.
Johnny got a zero today.
Oh, he couldn't concentrate on studies.
He never studied.
His mind was always in the sky.
In the sky. When he grew up, he left his buddy. And Johnny learned how to fly, 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 fly.
Oh, now they still call him Johnny Zero. And all the pilots proudly say,
Johnny got a zero, he got another zero. Johnny is the hero today. Johnny Zero.
profound flame for our land.
Johnny Zero got another zero. Johnny Zero is a hero today.
Boot that. Right here, we're going down in the mail room and tie up a package for the gang at 929 who signed themselves, quote, Smitty, A-W-O-L, Homer, Padre, Corporal Zoot Fahey, and Panky Smitherpuss. And I'd like to call Little Gloria Lowe on Davy Street in Hobart, Tasmania. Honey, you said some mighty sweet things about old command performance, and big-hearted Johnny Doughboy wants you to share his big show with him. Now's a good time to start, too, because G.I. Joe has campaigned for and elected for tonight's command performance one of America's great torch singers. Fellas, here's Gertrude Neeson.
Hiya, fellas, and hello, Professor.
Evening, Gertie.
Kay, I'm thrilled to be here on Command Performance. I've heard so much about the show and the fact that every week it has on it the most prominent, the biggest stars in Hollywood.
Well, that's right.
And I was dying to come tonight because I knew I'd probably work opposite one of the handsomest, the most exciting, romantic men in Hollywood.
Of course, they told you you'd be on with Kay Kaiser.
Yes, but I came anyway.
Now, look, Gertie, I didn't come here to be insulted.
No?
No. If I wanted to be insulted, I could have stayed home and read my fan mail.
Oh. I was only kidding, Kay. I think you're very nice.
You do?
Mm-hmm. I think all the gentlemen here tonight are very nice. The soldiers, sailors, and marines out front, the boys in the band, the announcer, the boys in the control booth, those little ushers running up and down.
You like men, I gather.
I like men anybody gathers.
Say, Gertie, I think it's high time we got around to a song. What's it going to be?
Well, how about Begin the Begin?
My dear Gertrude, the Begin is practically begun. Hit it, boys.
When they begin the Begin, it brings back the sound of music so tender. It brings back a night of tropical splendor. It brings back a memory evergreen. I'm with you once more under the stars, and down by the shore an orchestra's playing, and even the palms seem to be swaying. When they begin to begin, we'll live it again. It's power, except when that tune clutches my heart. And there we are, swearing to love forever, and promising never, never to part. What moments divine, what rapture serene, till clouds came along to disperse the joys we had tasted. And now when I hear people curse the chance that was wasted, I know but too well what they mean. So don't let them begin. I only remember when they begin the begin. Oh, yes, let them begin the begin. Make suddenly know what heaven we're in when they begin the begin.
Ah, that was great, Gertie. Just great, and thanks a lot. Well, men, long before a terrific MGM picture called Cabin in the Sky, you guys were writing from all over the world asking for more of a gal by the name of Lena Horne. Now, Corporal Jesse L. Balthazar at 989 is a Lena Horne fan, and so is Mrs. Balthazar, who's on duty with the wax. In a Canadian military hospital at CAPO3, the gang says Lena Horne is top. Well, Lena's one of the brightest new stars on the old Hollywood horizon. And in Cabin in the Sky, she teams up with a fellow who's walking up to the mic right now. He's walking up to the mic to say...
Hello there, Professor Kaiser. This is Rochester.
Well, Rochester, it's about time you showed up. Why are you so late?
Due to conditions beyond my control, I had to attend a birthday party for Mr. Benny.
Well, so Jack had a birthday party. Tell me, how old is Jack?
31.
31? That's carrying loyalty too far. Did he have a birthday cake?
He sure did.
Were there 31 candles on it?
There was on the piece I got.
Tell me, Rochester, was it a good party? Who entertained?
I did. I played a piano solo with my feet.
You play a piano solo with your feet? Well, what do you do with your hands?
Hold them over my ears. I can't stand it.
Well, say, was there any other entertainment?
Sure, Mr. Benny got out his violin and played us a nice solo.
Well, what did he play?
Mr. 4x4.
That's 5x5.
He gets it wholesale. Well, Mr. Kaiser, I'm sorry, but I've got to run along now. Got a date waiting for me outside.
A date?
Yeah, I'm taking my girl to the movies. We're going to that new picture, Action in the North Balcony.
Listen, Action in the North Balcony. That's Action in the North Atlantic. You don't know your movie.
You don't know my girl.
Now, wait a minute, Rochester. Before you run along, you've got a little date right here on Command Performance with Lena Horne.
Lena Horne, is she here?
You bet she is, fellas. Lena Horne!
Hello, fellas. Hello, Rochester. And, Professor, what can I do for you?
Well, we sort of figured, Lena, the boys would like to hear that great number you and Rochester sing in your new picture, Cabin in the Sky.
Oh, you mean consequences.
I mean consequences.
Well, consequence away. Life's full of consequence, that old devil consequence. He takes all the frivol out of fun. When you got the candle lit at both ends, the scandal it creates always keeps you on the run. Just when you weaken in, fate sends the deacon in. Crash and your bash ain't worth an ounce. 'Cause then comes the consequence, that old devil consequence flings you back with a bounce.
Consequence, but who's scared of consequence? Let's sip the honey while it's sweet. We could be messing round, but you is digressing round while I'm tossing nature at your feet. Why don't we mosey round? You could be cozy round the gal who could sprinkle you with spice.
But how about the consequence, that old devil consequence? I've been fine more than fine. I ain't paying the price.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, Rochester and Lena Horn. Well, men, ever since Pearl Harbor, Command Performance has honored your request for the greatest entertainers in America. And tonight, we give you America's most intelligent personality. The inspiration for all the moron jokes, Ishkabibble.
Ishkabibble's news events. United Press from the front, Associated Press from the rear. Pants press while you wait. Pants press while you wait.
Oh, fine.
Berlin. Hitler sick. Reported to have 1 foot in the grave.
You mean grave.
Great.
Grave?
Great. Where he's going, he's going to burn. Ain't that great?
Yes, it is. But, Ish, this is Command Performance. You should do something more personal.
Oh, well, I got a poem here I made up out of my own head, which I would like to read for a friend of mine somewhere in the Combination Islands.
Where are the Combination Islands?
Just east of the West Indies.
West Indies, well, that should cover everything. Read, Umbrella Head.
Okay, poem. Oh, there was a young lady named Hetty who wanted a guy to go steady. But whenever she found one who was willing and ready, the draft board was there before Hetty.
Fine poetry. Just great.
Well, you know, poetry is all the rage now. In fact, I've written a poem in regards to life, which you would probably relish hearing same.
Read.
There was a young man from Perth who was born on the day of his birth. He got married, they say, on his wife's wedding day, and he died on his last day on earth.
Ish, that's silly. Now, let's be serious. Do you have an essay?
Well, Professor, on account of there are so many of these here now, fellas who write to Command Performance that have got their wings, I have wrote an essay in regards to which I would like to read, same entitled, Feathers.
Feathers. All right, Ish. Read.
Feathers. Feathers is stuff that if it was a cold night and a chicken didn't have any, she'd liable to get her Adam's apple froze off if she had one, but she ain't, so she couldn't. Now, the way to tell the difference between a rooster and a hen is to put some corn down on the ground. Now, if he eats it, it's a rooster, but if she eats it, it's a hen. Now, feathers is kind of clothes for chickens and birds, but don't never try to give your girl a feather duster when she wants a fur coat, because when it comes to fur, if you don't give your girl a coat made of it, you won't get very.
All right. Thank you, Ish. Now we're handing Command Performance over to my whole gang in a special medley we've cooked up to answer your commands for the great spirituals. See which one of these answers your letter.
Ezekiel saw that wheel way in the middle of the air. Yes, Ezekiel saw that wheel way in the middle of the air. Now the big wheel runs by the faith, and the little wheel runs by the grace of God. We're within that wheel way in the middle of the air.
Wheel, wheel, wheel.
Hallelujah.
Wheel in the middle of the air. Wheel,
wheel, wheel. Hallelujah.
Wheel in the middle of the air.
Now the big wheel run by the faith.
Hallelujah.
And the little wheel run by the grace of God. Wheel within that wheel.
Hallelujah. Way in the middle of the air. In the middle of the
air. Thank you a lot. Well, gang, it's about time for the swing shift to come in, so we'll be punching out right about here. But we'll punch in again next week and every week for you guys who are punching it out with the axes. Thanks a lot for those swell letters that bring in the entertainment orders to this big show of yours. And always remember, those letters are first on the order of business of the entertainment business. We're sorry to break up this party, but I'm mighty glad to have been invited. So, with best wishes from the whole mob over here, this is Kay Kaiser speaking from the USA, saying good luck, gang, and so long, everybody.
This is Ken Carpenter yanking down the curtains and turning on the nightlight and taking one last look around to note that Command Performance is arranged through the cooperation of the Hollywood Victory Committee and produced for you men of the Armed Forces of the United Nations by the Special Service Division of the War Department of the United States of America.